What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and it is September and time to look at the current state of crypto mining and profitability. Starting off with GPUs, we'll swap over to ASICs, some FPGAs like the E300, some CPUs, and kind of compare that to last month. The whole purpose behind this is when we hit the bull market and so on, we can look back and see exactly how everything did transition month on end. So it's some nice statistics to have for history purposes, and then we're going to fall into a future bear market again and kind of look back one more time. All right, so here we are with GPUs and 11 cent per kilowatt hour, and we can see the RTX 4090 is about 47 cent profit after power, but this is coming in at it's an expensive GPU. There's no ifs, ands about it. It's also melting for a lot of people. You know, if you're gamers, you're having a bad day with these GPUs. But the ROI is currently over 3,000 days. That's a little high. You know, obviously that's going to drop down quite a bit, hopefully, in the bull market. But we're a ways away from that. And it looks like Peppy Power, PPU, happening here is the top coin. And scrolling down, you know, getting down to the more common GPUs, the 3000 series is still some of the most popular NVIDIA based GPUs, and they are looking, which I can't even find right now. What is going on? Where's the 3070? There's a laptop version. No, time the 3070 is way under the laptop. It's possible though. We got the 3060 here, -1 cent. Okay, that sucks. We got 1660s breaking even, so I guess that's okay, but still sucks. We got 6600s making 5 cents on Dynex. 3070 must be up here. Like, what is going on? Is it literally utter trash right now? Is that a thing? Maybe. Oh wow, is it? No way, is it seriously way down here? A 3070. 3090 is way down here at -4. Okay, so is the 3070 seriously not making anything right now? No way. Okay, let's find out. This is a bad month. This is a really bad month if that's the case. What the heck? Did they get rid of... Maybe they got rid of the 3070. I am blind half the time, so, you know, I can't find things, but... What? What the heck? Seriously? Okay, I'm doing this one more time. 4070. 4070. Green. Green. 4060 Ti. 3090 Ti. I just can't believe my eyes. I can't believe my eyes that a 3070 is like... Either they were so bad, they just wiped it right off the list completely. There we go. We found it. -3 cents. Oh, my gosh. if you want to dual mine, you can get yourself some Conflux and Radiant here by the looks of things for -10 cents. You know, that sounds like a good day. Not. Anyway, so we're looking at -3 cents on an RTX 3070. If we just look back from last month, let's open this big so we can kind of see so I can compare. Last month, GPUs were looking a lot better. Look at Clore here on a lot of these GPUs here. We have a 3090 here making 30 cents after power, making 29, 28, 27. Look at these GPUs. GPUs were doing pretty good last month. This month, not happening. This month, they suck. All right, so now that we're done with that nightmarish GPU thing, getting shivers. Anyway, let's take a look at the current statistics courtesy of HiveOS and HiveOn network statistics. So the major coins right now, which are the most popular, now everyone does not use HiveOS or anything. You know, there's a lot of people in Windows, a lot of people in RaveOS and MinerStat and other various OSs out there, but HiveOS is one of the largest and most popular. And we can see the most popular coin on HiveOS being mined right now is Dynex. It's at 17%. We got ETC at 9%, Raven at 6%, Nex at 6%, RXD at 6%, Kaspa is at 5%, we got Ergo at 3%, we even got XMR here, a CPU coin, 3%. Looks like there's a bunch here tied for 3%, Alephium, Zil, we got Bitcoin being mined at 2%, and you can see everything down from there. Now for algorithms, the most popular algorithms on GPUs. Now these are the coins being mined in HiveOS of most popularity. Now in most popularity in terms of the GPUs itself, it looks like Dynex Solve is being used here. So Dynex again, 17% of GPUs is mining Dynex. We got Kapow is in second place, so all the Kapow based coins. We got ETC hash at 9%, Nexapow at 6%, RandomX at 6%, SHA 52256D here is 6%, and ETHash algorithms at 5%. We got GR at 5%, and you can kind of see them go down from there for the GPU size. When it comes to AMD models of GPUs, the top dog AMD model is 23% RX 580 8 gigabyte models, and the top GPU for NVIDIA is the RTX 3070's 8 gigabyte edition, and the most popular ASIC is the L3 Plus at 43%. Now, let's scroll down here for a minute, and as you can see, the most popular miners. Some people had this question in the past, and LOL Miner is tied with 10 Miner at 11%. Now, before, LOL Miner was the most popular miner being used, and then we looked up here and we saw Dynex was the most popular algorithm. So how does that work? So LOL Miner, it can actually be used for a lot of these coins. That is why you see LOL Miner in the lead, because people are using it for various things like maybe Kapow, Nexapow, and so on. All those various algorithms where Dynex Solve is only being used by one single miner when it comes to the NVIDIA side, and that is 10 Miner. So that's why we're kind of seeing mixed up of numbers here. This is one coin being used on this miner, where LOL Miner is being used on multiple coins. And leading into that, we can see that we did see 23% RX 580s, but not many GPUs are actually AMD. 70% of all GPUs is NVIDIA, and we only have 30% of the GPUs in HiveOS are in fact AMD. And then of that 30%, is 23% being the RX 580. So that's kind of what we got going on here in terms of this. The majority of the GPUs being used are NVIDIA, and most of them are on Dynex. All right, so now let's have a quick look at some CPU mining profitability. I'm just going to load up the 3900X again, do a recalculation so it's up to date, and we can see that Zeph is currently making about 19 cents after power and 48 cents before power. We got Avian here at 16 cents after power. This is all 11 cents per kilowatt hour, just like the GPUs. Bittorium, 7 cents. Pulsar, 7 cents. Monero is at 6%. Yattacoin, 5%. Raptorium, 4%. Viruscoin, 4 cents. Did I say 4% or 4 cents here? I meant 4 cents, but I don't know, something sounded out wrong. And Viruscoin, obviously, we got 4 cents here, and they just get worse, worse, and worse. Now let's kind of jump into the 7950X here. This is a nice, more efficient over than the 3900X. We're seeing more profitability at 68 cents free power, 34 cents after power, Avian 31. You can kind of see what these numbers look like. Now we're going to jump into the Epic 7742, load that bad boy up, and we're seeing Zeph is 95 cent profitability and $1.83 if you had free power. Avian is 76 cents. Viruscoin is actually 48 cents. It's actually doing pretty good here, Viruscoin, on this thing. And Monero is 46 cents and 43 cents there. And for the big daddy right here, the Bitmain X5, which just recently released, can only mine RandomX. I did put in Ghost Rider numbers, but I don't think it's going to have the ability to mine this. Only a few RandomX coins is what it's kind of sound like, but we don't know for sure. And the profitability here is $4.55 after power, $8.11 if you had free power, and Monero is $2.40 and $5.97. But again, unknowns are what coins can this thing even mine. All right, so let's move into some ASIC miners here, and we can see the Bitmain KS3 is obviously still the top choice here, but it is down to $253. Let's have another look at the KS0 here right quick. It is at $2.99 a day, making 91.4 Kaspa. I do have it set. Last month, look at these numbers. So the KS3 was in first with $1,655 a day, mining 43,000 coins, where the KS0 here from Ice River, 521 coins and $19.88 a day. Let's go right back to where we are right now. Look at that, 7,588 coins. Look at the massive drop that these miners have seen. Now the profitability on the KS3 is still looking pretty darn good, but it's definitely down quite a bit, and the KS0 is barely making the top 10 anymore, and that's going to continue to go down. Actually, in about 3 days' time, we're going to see another reward drop on Kaspa with those block rewards, bringing all these down even more on top of the hash rate picking up. But let's continue on. We got the X16P, about $9.49 per day profitability at 11 cents per kilowatt hour. Not too bad. 5.8 gigahash miner at 1900 watts. We got the L7 9.5 gigahash version, about $3.60 per day. That's definitely come down quite a bit since the halving, as well as the dip in the market we're currently seeing. We got the K7 rocking about $3.35. Now, I'm very interested about this miner right here because I may have the opportunity to get Canadian hosting at 9 cents per kilowatt hour, which works out to be 7 cents USD. So I've been looking at this K7 for this very reason. So 335 actually per day. If I drop this to 7 cents per kilowatt hour for USD rates, that K7 is now about $6.31. That's actually not too bad considering we're at like very bad bear market time. So the bull run could be awesome, but you know, I'm still up in the air. I'm thinking about actually purchasing this miner, but I don't know, and then sending that over to someone that will host this for me at this cheap power price. Back to 11 cents per kilowatt hour, we got the Jazzminer X16Q, about $3.24. Not too bad. How's its rival, the E9 Pro? We're gonna have to go way down for this one. 91 cents. Yeah, that $2,200 versus the X16Q, $2,900. So the price has been coming down on the Jazz miners here. And, you know, they're just so much better than this piece of junk right here. But regardless, a lot of people consider any ASIC junk, and it's all in perspective and what you want to mine. They are limited to only one coin or one algorithm, so there is that to deal with. So regardless, this is our current profitability of ASIC miners. All right, so now let's check out the E300 for FPGAs. Now, in theory, I could add Ethereum Classic to this list, but I feel that the Jazz miners and the iPolos are just better off. And the same could be said for Kaspa. I should probably eliminate Kaspa from this list because it's not doing very good anymore. We can see we're losing 60 cents per day mining with the E300 on Kaspa. Again, you know, if Kaspa does pump, you're still getting 12.95 coins here. We could be, if it hits a dollar, that's still $12.95 a day. So there's still that little bit of gamble that could pay off long run, but then you're probably just better off mining something else like Ironfish here, for example. It is making you 84 cents per day, and then just swapping that over into Kaspa, you would end up getting more Kaspa than mining it directly and trying to cover your power bill. Now, Kyla coin was a top coin for quite some time, but we can see we're actually losing on it now at negative 46 cents at 11 cents per kilowatt hour. Now, I'm just going to rewind to last month, and things were looking a little bit different here. We could see Ironfish was actually making $2.09. We were making 72 cents on Kyla coin, and Kaspa was still making $1.75 last month on this E300. So things are definitely changing pretty fast here, but these are the current network conditions of things, and it's looking like if you do have one of these and you are shooting for profitability, Ironfish is currently your best bet. All right, guys, so that pretty much does sum up this video. We took a look at some ASIC mining hardware and equipment in various different types, depending who you are and what you like to mine with, for the month of September. We'll be back doing it again next month for October. Hope this video helped you out. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.